Without further ado, let's get to it. The first division we will be going over today, as we will be starting off in the AFC, is the AFC South. And the AFC South is such an interesting division because I feel like historically, we look at these teams, the Titans and the Colts and the Jaguars and the Texans, and even going into this season, I feel like a lot of people would consider the AFC South to be one of the worst and most boring divisions in football. However, the way I see it, when I look at this division, I actually really like and am intrigued by the amount of possible storylines going in. Each team has one in particular. When you look at the Tennessee Titans, they lose Arthur Smith, a guy that I think was very, very important to making this Tennessee Titan offense one of the best offenses in the league over the past couple of years. And we saw, since he started to work with Arthur Smith, just how much of an improvement Ryan Tannehill had going back to his days as the quarterback of the Miami Dolphins. We look at the Indianapolis Colts and their quarterback situation. I really did think at many times during the season last year that the Indianapolis Colts were literally just a quarterback away. One of those moments were in the playoff game against the Buffalo Bills, where I really did think that even though Phillip Rivers, I think, had a good regular season, I think he was about as good as anyone could have really asked for him to be. The Indianapolis Colts did not have a quarterback that was able to make plays and put the team on his back during that playoff game against the Bills, and I think at many other times during the Colts season. I think the lack of quarterback play could have been one of the many reasons why ultimately it was the Tennessee Titans who ended up winning the AFC South last year. We know everything that has been going on as of late with Deshaun Watson and the Houston Texans situation. Deshaun Watson has 22 lawsuits against him right now. Obviously, we don't know what the results of those lawsuits are or what really is going to happen. But I do think if he was on another team, a team that he really wanted to play for, then he would have already been on the commissioner's exempt list already. Roger Goodell just didn't really bother with it yet because he knows Deshaun Watson doesn't really plan on never playing another snap for the Houston Texans again. So Goodell was just like, yeah, there's no point if he's not going to play anyway. We all know everything going on with Deshaun and his thoughts on the Texans organization. We'll obviously have to wait and see until all of the stuff off the field gets cleaned up. And even the Jacksonville Jaguars, we saw them on Monday Night Football in a preseason game a couple weeks ago against the New Orleans Saints, and Urban Meyer and Trevor Lawrence and everything that those two guys bring to the table. I think part of what makes the NFL such a great sport is that the Jacksonville Jaguars, a team that has been around for the past 20, 25 years, and to be honest with you guys, no one has really cared about them. They've made a couple AFC championship games, but I never remember going into a season saying, wow, I'm actually really looking forward to everything going on with the Jacksonville Jaguars this season. I have rarely said, okay, I'm going to make time to watch the Jacksonville Jaguars play a game on Sunday. But I do believe for the first time in a long time this season, there are going to be people who want to watch Urban Meyer and want to watch Trevor Lawrence and see everything that's going on in Jacksonville. So I do think the AFC South is a super intriguing division, even though from the outside, a lot of football fans won't realize it. To start off, my pick to win the AFC South is going to be the Indianapolis Colts. And right now, when you look at the Colts, their over-under win total in Vegas is 9 on the dot, and they are plus 125 to win the AFC South. The Tennessee Titans are minus 150 to win the South. If you're not sure what those terms mean, if you want to bet $100 on the Colts, you would win $125 for them to win the AFC South. For the Titans, if you want to win $10, you would have to risk $15. $100, you would have to risk $150. They are the favorite, Tennessee is. But for Indianapolis, they are my pick to win this division with a record of 10-7. And Indianapolis is a team that I really like, starting with their GM and their coach. When Carson Wentz went down earlier in the preseason with what a lot of people thought to be a broken foot, I just remember sitting back and saying to myself, What has Frank Reich and Chris Ballard done to the football gods for them to just have the absolute worst luck in terms of everything that has gone down over the last couple of years? We know that Josh McDaniels originally was supposed to be the one who replaced Chuck Pagano a couple of years ago as the head coach in Indianapolis, and Josh McDaniels said, screw it. I do not want to be the head coach of the Indianapolis Colts. I would rather stay in New England as their offensive coordinator. We obviously know everything that went down with Andrew Luck. He not only retires when most people thought he had a good 3-4 years left, but he retires right before the start of the season, leaving Indianapolis in a tough spot. They ultimately ended up going with Jacoby Brissett. And we know what has happened since then. And then this year with Carson Wentz, their starting quarterback, a guy that they gave up a first-round pick for, he went down. However, if you are a Colt fan, it does look like Carson Wentz and Quentin Nelson, one of the best probably the best offensive guard and offensive lineman in the league. I think a Hall of Fame, once-in-a-generational type player at offensive guard. It looks like him and Wentz, who suffered a similar type of foot injury, it looks like both of those guys are going to be on the field for the Indianapolis Colts week one against the Seattle Seahawks. I think if you are an Indianapolis Colt fan, that is great, great news. And it just comes down to this for me, right? I have always been a Carson Wentz believer. I understand that. I will tell you that. I was a guy that has been super high on the Philadelphia Eagles over the last couple of years based on him being their starting quarterback. And in some instances, I've been right. In some instances, I have been wrong. But one thing is for certain. Last year, Carson Wentz was one of the worst quarterbacks in the league. He lost the Philadelphia Eagles many games, and he just was not good. And there are no excuses for that. We all know that in Philadelphia, Carson Wentz and Doug Peterson had a rough, rough ending. But another thing I know for sure is that Carson Wentz and Frank Reich have played together before. Reich has coached Wentz before. And I've heard in many interviews over the course of the offseason that Frank Reich and Carson Wentz speak the same football language. They both know what's going on. They both know each other's strengths and each other's weaknesses. And I do trust and believe in Frank Reich and Chris Ballard and that Colts regime that they brought in the right player and the right quarterback in Carson Wentz. I think the good news, if you're a Colt fan, is that you don't really need Carson Wentz to be the main reason why you're winning and losing games. You just need him not to screw up, not to turn the ball over. And I think Frank Reich and Chris Ballard, I just trust them. They've done a great job building this roster from guys like Quentin Nelson on the offensive line. They also have some young skill position players that I think could be really good in Jonathan Taylor and Michael Pittman. And that defense just has some dogs, man. Darius Leonard is a player that could play for my team any day of the week. I'm also a huge DeForest Buckner fan. They gave up a first-round pick for him, but I think it's well worth it. He is a miniature version of Aaron Donald. He is that good. He could get to the quarterback. I also really like Julian Blackman, the safety they drafted last year from Utah. He was one of the better rookies on defense in the NFL last year. I believe in this Colts defense. I really do. I believe in Frank Reich, and I do think that Carson Wentz, knowing that this is it for him, if he does not succeed this season, it is going to be very hard for Carson Wentz to be a starting quarterback in the NFL. And yes, Carson Wentz, he was one of the worst quarterbacks in the league last year, and he was terrible. He needs to be better than that if this Indianapolis Colts team wants to win football games. But I think he will be better than that, and I do think the Colts, and with their quarterback knowing that if he doesn't succeed this season, they are my pick to win the AFC South. Now, the team I have finishing in second with a record of 8-9, and I know that record, 8-9, it's going to surprise some people. It's the Tennessee Titans. Right now in Vegas, the Titans over-under number in terms of win total is 9.5, so I would go with the under there. The Titans, once again, are the favorite to win the AFC South at minus 150. And when it comes to the Titans, I just have some concerns with this team. Last year, the Tennessee Titans offense was so good. It was so dynamic, and they deserve credit. They deservedly so won that AFC South, but I just think regression could be coming. And it's funny because I said that before the season started last year for Tennessee. I wasn't 100% sure if Ryan Tannehill would be able to continue everything he did in 2019. Because when the Titans beat New England and they made that deep, deep playoff run, getting to the AFC Championship game against the Chiefs, they also had a really good end to the regular season that year. I didn't think it was all Ryan Tannehill. Like, Derrick Henry had a lot to do with that, and obviously Derrick Henry is just a once in a generational type talent. It's very rare that you see a player being able to do what he has done over the last couple years, just being able to sit there and put the Titans team on his back, running for 2,000 yards back to back years. Is he able to make it three this year? We shall see. But the Titans lose Arthur Smith, a guy that I think was crucial to their offense and creativity and ability to put up points. The problem with Tennessee for me, though, is last year, these guys were literally one of the worst defenses in football. They signed Jadeveon Clowney, who was a massive, massive bust. And they didn't really do anything to replace him because he didn't do anything to begin with. Now, they do bring in Bud Dupree. His injuries worry me. He obviously tore his ACL before last season ended in Pittsburgh. And I just don't trust this Titan defense, period. Janoris Jenkins, Christian Fulton at corner was the kid they drafted from LSU. They bring in Amani Hooker. Like, there are names on this defense, and there's no reason why it should be as bad as it's been over the last couple of years. But this defense just gave up way too many points last year, and I don't think this year their offense is going to be able to outscore their defense's inefficiencies. I like Mike Vrabel as a head coach. I think he's really overachieved since the start of his tenure as head coach of the Tennessee Titans, but I just think the Indianapolis Colts are a way more complete team than Tennessee. I trust Frank Reich a smidge more than Mike Vrabel, and even though Tennessee might have the better quarterback, I think Indianapolis's offensive line and defense is so much better than Tennessee's that ultimately it will give them the edge. I just don't think Ryan Tannehill is going to be able to lead this offense to outscore all the points that their defense is ultimately going to give up. I like Indy in first in the AFC South, Tennessee in second. In third in this AFC South, I will have the Jacksonville Jaguars with a record of 4-13. And it's funny because I actually think there's some talent on the Jaguars. Obviously, we know just how talented of a quarterback Trevor Lawrence is. James Robinson, DJ Chark, Laviska Shenault is a young wide receiver I really like. And by the way, I said 4-13. I actually meant 3-14 for my final record prediction for the Jacksonville Jaguars. But I just watched that preseason Monday night game, Jaguars-Saints, a couple weeks ago, and I just saw Urban Meyer on the sideline, and it really did hit me. It is so hard to make the transition from college to the NFL. In college, you literally have all of the power over the players. You could threaten them with anything. There is really no guaranteed roster spot for them. You, like, obviously, it's a player's going to has to do something major to get cut from a college team, like cheat or something, or just really mess up. But at the same time, you're the coach. You have all the power. In the NFL, these players are getting paid. They're under contract. Some players are getting paid more than you. There are some guys off the field that have kids that have to deal with 3-4 baby mamas. Like, Urban Meyer has a lot to learn in that regard, and it's really not easy. And even though Urban is one of the best college coaches I've ever seen, I do not think this operation is going to work with the Jaguars. I would at least not right away, and probably not in the near future. I just cannot trust this Jaguars franchise as far as I could throw them. And the more I look at this hire, it's kind of giving me some John Gruden vibes as a hire that was made to really only impress the fans and get them excited. Obviously, the Jaguars have been super irrelevant in Jacksonville over the last couple of years. And I do think if you're a Jaguar fan and you want one positive, it's going to be that other people for the first time in a while are actually going to be interested in viewing and watching your games. But at the same time, I just don't see them being very good on the football field. And I do think there's a reason why, when you ask a lot of people in football circles, who do we think ultimately is going to be the best quarterback in this draft class? Even though for the last couple years, while watching him at Clemson, we've all said that Trevor Lawrence is a once in a generational type quarterback prospect that any team would be lucky to get their hands on. There's a reason why no one is saying that long term he's going to be the best one in this group. And I think a lot of it has to do with the situation. I cannot trust this Jaguar team as far as I could throw them. They will be my prediction to come in third place in the AFC South with a record of 3-14. They are plus 650 to win the South, and right now their over-under win total is 6.5. I will take the under there. And then finally, the team I am finishing in fourth place with a record of 2-15 is the Houston Texans, who it's just unbelievable in the past 2 years. Everything that has gone on with this team. It really doesn't seem like that long ago the Houston Texans were sitting here with Deshaun Watson as their starting quarterback, DeAndre Hopkins as their top wide receiver, and there were things to be really optimistic about. But then owner Cal McNair decided to give Bill O'Brien really all of the power, and he traded DeAndre Hopkins. The Texans were up 24-0 in the AFC divisional playoffs in Arrowhead Stadium against the Kansas City Chiefs, and they blew that lead so fast, and really nothing has been the same since. And it's just crazy because this is what happens when you're just an unorganized, undisciplined organization with power struggles all over the place. We know that Jack Easterby, the former minister or church choir leader in New England, him and Deshaun Watson didn't get along because Jack Easterby was really the guy making all of the football related decisions. Deshaun Watson wasn't too thrilled about that, and he wants to be traded. And now everything that's been going on off the field with Deshaun Watson, it is really a question mark if he's ever going to be able to play football again for the Houston Texans, if he ever will. But it might be a while until we see Deshaun. And I think Nick Cesario, the Texans GM, is a guy I wanted to talk about a little bit. I don't trust this guy. I don't love what he's all about. The Texans have been bringing in guys from New England under that Belichick model from the past couple years, and I think when you're doing that from a head coaching perspective, we've really seen that not be able to work. Now you're doing that with a general manager. You're bringing in executives from New England who really haven't accomplished anything, and Nick Cesario was out here letting Deshaun Watson be the talk in NFL circles during training camp, even though we all know he's really not going to probably play this season. If I'm the Houston Texans, I would have just sent Deshaun Watson home instead of wasting everyone's time and letting him be the fourth team quarterback or the first string scout safety. Like, I don't know. It's a joke. It's really a joke, everything going on in Houston with Deshaun Watson and really how the whole situation has been handled. It obviously wasn't the Texans' fault that Deshaun Watson got involved with these 22 women, but at the same time, I just think they could have handled the situation a little better. They brought in guys like Mark Ingram and Philip Lindsay. They have Tyrod Taylor as their starting quarterback, but I do think this Texan team is not talented at all. They do have a chance to win their week one game against the Jacksonville Jaguars. And if Urban Meyer really wants to get off to at least a somewhat good start, win that game. Because if you lose to the Houston Texans, a team that a lot of people are saying could win only one or two games this season, that is just going to be an awful, awful start for the Jacksonville Jaguars. Right now, the Texans over under win total is 4. I think they go 2-14 and go under that win total. So to recap my picks in the AFC South, I have the Colts winning the division with a record of 10-7. I'll go Tennessee in second, being one of the more disappointing teams in the NFL. I think they're due for regression. Record of 8-9. I will have the Jaguars in third, 3-14. Texans fourth, 2-15. Those are my thoughts on the AFC South.